Okay, hello. How are you doing? I'm almost done with your grading of your tests. I think there's one or two questions. I will finish it today and I will post your grade. Then, if any question, then let me know. Okay, so we are going to continue talking about this very important section 4.4. We talk about the vectors to be linearly dependent, independent. But if you, for a given vector space, you can find a very special set of independent vectors that behave like a machine that will generate every member of your space. So that would be a great help. That specific set of vectors is going to be called a basis. So we're going to define a basis and to see, it's very important to know the basis, at least one basis for each. Okay, vector space. So we're going to discuss this one, quite interesting chapter, and you're going to see two problems from this one on your quiz. Okay, so let's get back to my camera and give you those numbers. Okay, that's it, it's 4.4. Okay, it's going to be 4.4, and the idea is what is the basis in a vector space. Okay, so we're going to see. Okay, this is it. A basis. Okay, this is it. Or the basis. Okay, it's a basis. A basis for a vector space, or basis in the vector space. Vector space. Okay, that's it. So a definition is going to be, it's going to be a set of vectors that we do two operation for us, okay? That we do two operation for us. One of them is, remember, they are going to be linearly independent, and every vector in the space is going to be a linear combination of the basic one, okay? So this is going to be a definition. So suppose V is a vector space. Okay, a vector space. This is going to be the one, and we have a set of basics, set of vectors that I call it V1, V2, up to the Vn. Okay, up to the Vn is going to be is a set of given vectors. Okay, given vectors in your vector space. If this is going to be the case, then B is going to be called, okay, B is called a basis. Okay, it's going to be a basis for V if it satisfies two conditions. Okay, the first condition is that this set must be linearly independent. B is going to be linearly independent. Okay, independent set of vectors. And the second part is every vector in the vector space is a linear combination of the one in the B. And you know that that means you can span vector space by this B. Okay, so two conditions. The first one is going to be linearly independent. You know that you just get those C1, V1, C2, V2 to the CVN. And you show that all those scalars happen to be zero. And the other one is any vector in the V can be written as a linear combination of the vectors in the basis, which is very good. Okay, so you have a machine. That machine give you all the members, okay? You can generate all the members in your vector space. So your job is to find it. So some popular one is, you see, the first one, this is going to be a popular one. This is it. If you say if B is going to be equal to, B is equal to the I, J, and K. Remember those three standard unit vectors in R3. If this is going to be the case, then you know that B is going to be a basis. B is going to be a basis for R3. Okay, for R3. You know that they are linear independent, and every vector in R3 is in the form of the IJK. Standard basis, okay, for R3. You can have for, you can have for the R4, R, in general, Euclidean, okay, Rn, if you like, get these numbers. Then there are some other famous ones that you're going to see in future, okay? So if you consider the vector space of polynomials with degree at most n, okay, so this is it. If B is going to be equal to, you get the 1x, x squared up to the, okay, up to the xn. Okay, if this is going to be the case, so then B is going to be, okay, B is a basis. B is going to be a basis for, okay, for Pn. Remember, the Pn is what? The Pn is going to be, okay, so the Pn is the vector space of, okay, you know that the polynomials, with degree at most, okay, of degrees to less than n, okay, at most n. Means, up to the n minus one, if you like. And so these are going to be now the standard case. But your job is a set of vector would be given to you, then you want to check to see if that vector is going to be a basis. So this is going to be a kind of question that you're going to see. And you have it already on your practice quiz. So the question is, we give you a set and we ask you to do it. We want to do the determine. Okay, determine whether the set of vector, okay, the following sets of vectors are going to be our basis. Okay, basis for R3. So three set of vectors would be given to, and then we ask you to see if this is going to be, the case. Okay, so I'm going to go to the next page to get it. And I'll just give you the vectors here. So it's a two parts. Okay, the first part is this one. Okay, the set of vectors are 1, 1, 1. And you have the 1, 2, 3. There are some other methods, quick one in future to get these, but for the time being, you have to stay with the method that we have so far. Okay, we go with the standard one so far. So this is it. We get the 1, 2, and 5. And then you have the 5. 3 and 5. Again, this is two sets of vectors. We want to know if this is going to be a basis for R3. So we have to check the two conditions that we talk about it. You have to check the condition that they are going to be, okay, linearly independent. And the other one is you have to check to see if any arbitrary vectors in R3 is a linear combination of these three, okay? So I'm going to check it. Okay, this is it. This is very a standard method that we're going to use for all the similar problems. Okay, so this is it. Solution. I go with the first one. Okay, so I just remind you what we have for the first one, we may call it B. So I have a 1, 1, 1. Okay, this is a 1, 1, 1, and this is a 1, 2, 3. And I have the 2, negative 1, and 1. And I like to call them, okay, V1, V2, and V3. Okay, what I need to prove? So I need to show that, or I show, one should. Okay, one must show, if you like. Must show that. Okay, you have to show that they are linearly independent. So you must show that the vectors, if you like, show that the, I just remind you, the vectors, okay, the vectors are independent. Okay, independent and the span. And a span, okay, a span R3. Okay, a span R3 means that for the linear independent, this means if, okay, if C1, C2, and C3 are scalars, okay, are going to be a scalar such that this linear combination, you have the C1 V1 plus C2 V2 and plus C3 V3 is equal to the 0. Okay, then C1 is equal to the C2 equal to the C3 is equal to the 0. This is the one that you have to prove. And also at the same time, what you have to prove also, at the same time, if you pick a vector, if B equal to the B1, B2, B3 is going to be in R3, is in R3, it's going to be just a linear combination of V1, V2, then you have to prove that, okay, you have to prove that there are a scalar C1, C2, and C3, okay, such that B is equal to, okay, such that the C1 V1 plus C2 V2 plus C3 V3 is equal to the B1 comma B2 and the B3. You see, this is what you have to prove at the same time. Now, if you substitute these, okay, if you substitute and form this equation that give you a system of two equation, two variables. Okay, so from the first one, okay, I'm going to call this one number one, if you like, and this is going to be number two. So if you simplify the number one, you're going to get this one. We already talk about it. You see, we can write it down, the first one, okay, the first component, so that give you C1. Because it's going to be multiplying the first component, they're going to be C1, C2, minus plus 2, C3 equal to the 0. Okay, and the second component that give you C1, 2, C2, minus C3, C1, 2, C2, minus C3 equal to the 0. Okay, and the third one, C3, you see, C3, 3 C3. Okay, and the this is going to be the third component, C1, 3 C2, and the C3. So that gives you C1, 3 C2, okay, and the C3. This must be 0, this is from the first one. And from the second one, you see the first part is the same. And you have the B1, B2, B3. So from the second one, you have this system of the equation. You see the first part is, this is a homogeneous one, we get 0, 0. But over here, you have some numbers, we call it non-homogeneous. That would be B1, and this would be C1, 2 C2 minus C3 equal to the B2. And this would be C1, 3 C2, and C3 equal to the B3. You see, that's going to be your system. So if you consider the coefficient of the, you know that if you want to solve it, you have to consider the matrix of the coefficient of the system, but the matrix of the coefficient would be exactly the same thing. Okay, so you are going to consider the coefficient matrix. Okay, if you consider the coefficient matrix of both system, matrix of both systems, you get only one. You see, you get this one. It's A equal to, and that's it. You get a 1, 1, 2. That's the first part. Okay, then you get a 1, 2, -1. And the other one would be 1, 3, 1. You see, that's the one. Remember, we change this one into the AX equal to the B. If this matrix is going to be invertible, then you can have a solution. But otherwise, you don't. Okay, so you can find the determinant of the matrix. You can simplify it if you like, but it's easy to find the determinant of the matrix. Okay, if you like, you can, you know, it depends. You can find it right away, but otherwise, you can change it a little bit. You don't have to. You see R2 into the R2 minus R1, and the R3, again, you don't have to. You can find the determinant right away. But if you do this one, let's make it a little bit easier. Okay, so that gives you 1, 1, 2. Okay, and this is going to be 0, 1, -3. And that gives you 0, 0, 2, -1. So you can find the determinant of this matrix right away. Okay, so the determinant of the A, the depth of the A, would be the same as the determinant of this matrix. You just consider this column, you see this column, and find the result. Okay, so simply that give you what? That give you 1, because this has 1, 1 times eliminate, so that give you a -1 here, -1 minus, you get it -6, +6. Okay, +6, and that give you 5. And 5 is not equal to the 0. Remember, when 5 is not equal to the 0, A is going to be invertible. When A is invertible, this is the kind of AX equal to the 0. So we get X equal to the 0. And over here, you get X equal to the A inverse B. So you have a solution. Okay, so this means A is invertible. A is invertible. Okay, A is going to be invertible, and the systems are consistent, if you like. The systems got the solutions or consistent, are going to be consistent. Okay, so the first one would give you C1 equal to the C2, C3 equal to the 0, because the matrix equation is AX equal to the 0. And the matrix equation over here is AX equal to the B. So X would be A inverse B. Okay, so for this first system, you get the C1, C2, C3 equal to the 0. And from the second system, you have a solution for the C1, C2, and C3. Okay, so this means the vectors form A. So therefore, B is a basis. Is going to be a basis for R3. Okay, it's very R3. It's a very nice method. Okay, you don't have to solve the system. Just focus on the matrix of the coefficients. And if this determinant is not 0, it's invertible. So this system would give you all the variables equal to 0, and this system give you a solution. So this means by the first one means they are linear independent. By the second one means they expand, a spanning subsets, if you like. So that's going to be the case, okay? So this is the way you solve your problems, the one that you have on your practice one. And we give you 1 on the quiz and checking the second part. So don't waste your time to find the solutions, etc., because you don't need the solution. You just need to see what is the possibilities. Okay, so checking the second part, The second part, the set of vectors are 1, 1, 2. Okay, 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 5. Okay, 1, 2, 5, and the 5, 5, 3, and 4. You see, that's the second one. So this is it. If you do the same thing that we talk about it. Okay, so I'm going to introduce this one as a B. 1, 1, 2. Okay, 1, 2, 5. And then I get a 5, 3, and 4. So I'm going to call it V1, V2, V3. Okay, do the same thing that we did to get the matrix of the coefficient this time. Okay, if you do the matrix of the coefficients, this is going to be your matrix of the coefficients, okay? So we change it a little bit. So the matrix of the coefficient for the system is going to be like the one that we did. So in this case, the coefficient matrix or coefficient of the matrix. Coefficient matrix of the system. Of the system is going to be, I can write the system, you know, you don't need it really. This is the way, let me just show you. You see, that's a C1, C1, C2, C3, that's it. So we get a C1 plus C2 plus 5C3. That was the first system. The second one, C1, 2C2, 3C3. It's going to be C1. Okay, C1, 2C2, and plus 3C3 equal to the 0. And over here, we get the 2C1 plus 5C2 plus 4C3 equal to the 0. We can see that, you know, the matrix of the coefficients are going to be, this is the matrix, is going to be, and you get the 1, 1, 5. Okay, these are going to be the column vector, if you like. You see the column vector. So this is going to be 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, and this is going to be 2, 5, 4 this time. You see, these vectors are going to be the column vectors. 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 5, and the 5, 3, 4. And you're going to see it in the next, section later on. In 4.7 or 4.6. But we check the determinant of this matrix. You can simplify it if you like, or you can keep it as is to find the determinant right away. Okay, so I simplify it. You can find the determinant easily, you know, as is. So I'm going to make a little bit of zeros. So the R2 into the R2 minus R1. And over here, I have the R3 into the R3 minus 2R1. Again, you don't have to. You can get the matrix right away. So the result is going to be 1, 1, 5. You get the 0, 1. Okay, you subtract these two. That gives you a negative 2, R2 minus R1. Then R3 minus 2R1, that gives you 0. Minus 2 and the positive 3 give you 3. The minus 10, negative 10, and the 6 would be a negative 6. Okay, this is it. So we can find the determinant just using this column again. So this time, the determinant of the A is going to be, the number is 1, you eliminate. Okay, so we get 1 times negative 6. Minus, you see negative 2 times 3 would be a negative 6, but there's a positive, so you make it into the 0. When the determinant is 0, you know that A is not invertible. So the system is not going to be dependent, okay? So A is not invertible. It's not invertible. And you can see it if you go one more step, you will find out the system is. Okay, you see, if you multiply this one by 3 and subtract it, that gives you a dependent system. Okay, so A is not invertible, and the system is, and the vectors. And the vectors are going to be are linearly dependent. Linearly dependent. Dependent. Okay, so B is not this time, it's not a basis. It's not a basis. Okay, that's going to be one. Okay, so you know, if you just go one more steps, you see, if you go one more step, if you multiply this one by 3 and subtract it, you get 0, 0, 0 here. So this system is going to be dependent. So this means we are going to have infinity many, many solutions. Okay, so this is the way we are going to check for the time being. Okay, we are going to do more in future, but it's easy to check. You can have it with the polynomials, with the matrices. Okay, we have it on that practice one. Then I put the solution for you. You can check. Now, so this is going to be the definition of a basis. We are going to have quite a lot to check for the basis. Okay, but there is something else from the basis that we are very much interested in. You see, look at the, if you have R3, we already talked about a standard basis, IJK. Okay, so when you are in R3, each vector is just a linear combination of IJK. So in those cases, you see the component of the vectors are going to be coordinate in, you know, in R3. So in R3, each point would have a coordinates. The first coordinate x1, x2, and x3. So look at this one. You see, look at this one. And this is 1, 1, 2. If you think about it as a vector in R3, you see, if it's going to be a vector in R3, 1, 1, 2. So it's going to be the first component, the second one, and the third one, because your space is three-dimensional. So what we would like to do is, so this is in R3. So what we'd like to do is, we would like to consider a vector space in general, not R3. You may have polynomials, matrices, okay, whatever you have. So we are going to consider a vector space, we call it V, and we would like to introduce something like this coordinate. You see, like the coordinate vectors that we have over here, okay? So it's just a vector space in general, it's not R3. So what we are going to do is, if you give me a vector space V and a basis, if you give me a vector space V and a basis B, so what does it mean? This means that those vectors in the basis are going to be linearly independent, and each vector in the vector space V is a linear combination of those vectors in a basis. When you like the linear combination, remember you have something like C1, C2, C3 to the Cn. If you take those coefficients out, they are numbers. You put them together, that gives you a vector. A vector in what? In Rn. So that vector in Rn, we call it coordinates of the given vector. Okay, so what we do really, it's very nice. What we do, if you give me any vector space, if you give me any vector space, then I can translate it, I can think about it as a, okay, as a Euclidean space. So that will help you quite a lot. This is a kind of geometric property that we are going to use it in future and the application that we have, okay? So if it's going to be R2, R3, you already got the coordinate system, if you like. But if I give you a general one, a vector space, V, you don't have the coordinate system. So what you can do, you can create a coordinate system. So it depends on the basis. So this idea is going to be called coordinates of a vector, or vector coordinates in a general vector space. It's easy operation, make sure you understand it. And we give you one question on the test, and there are three cases, and you have three problems on your practice one. Okay, so what is coordinates? What is going to be? Okay, what is going to be coordinates? Okay, this is it. What is coordinates of a vector? Of a vector. Okay, it's nice because we know that in R2, R3, Rn, we have coordinate vectors in general. But how about if it is a general case? Now, this is it. You need a basis. So if B equal to V1, V2, up to the Vn is a basis. Okay, it's going to vector space B. Okay, if this is going to be the case, then for each vector, you know that if it could be any vector, I can write on the linear combination of this. So for any, okay, for any vector V in the vector space V, okay, you know that there are going to be, okay, there are a scalar, unique scalar because of these bases. There are unique scalars C1, C2, up to the Cn numbers such that, you know that such that your vector is a linear combination of the one in the basis. C1, V1, C2, V2, up to the Cn, Vn. So we have to find them. Okay, because it's a basis, you know that since it's a basis, it's generated a space. So if you give me a vector in base in a space, I can write them as a linear combination of the basic one. So now these numbers, these scalars, C1, C2 to the Cn, they call coordinates. Okay, so if this is going to be the case, okay, so the scalars that you are going to find them, you know, the scalars C1, C2, up to the Cn are called coordinates. Coordinates of what? Coordinates of the vector V. V relative to, okay, relative to the basis. To the basis B, because you may have different bases, okay? You may have different bases in your vector space. So which one did you pick? We have the standard one, remember? We have the standard one all the time in R3. So the scalar C1, C2 to C3 is called the coordinates of the vector V relative to the, okay, relative to the, to the B. And that's going to be one. Now, the reason is, if you put them together, that give you a vector in Rn. You see the vector? The vector, we have C1, C2, up to the Cn. You see, if you get this one, this is going to be the case. This is in Rn. You see, you did have a general vector space, nothing to do with the Rn to start with. But now you have a copy here in Rn. Okay, so this vector is in Rn and is going to be called, okay, this is it, and is called, as we talk about it. Okay, so this is going to be called the coordinate vector. Okay, it's going to be called coordinate. Okay, it's called the coordinate vector. Coordinate vector of the vector V relative to the, okay, to the B, to the basis. And we have a notation for it, and is denoted by, you must get this notation. You see, we write the vector, which is V. Then this is it, we put a parenthesis around it, and then the B. Okay, so this is going to be equal to, is the C1, C2 up to the Cn. I use sometimes, you know, a bracket. So I think in your book, sometimes they use this one, or it's the same thing. Okay, it's more popular, but you can use either one, I don't mind. So that's it. Okay, so your job is to find it. Okay, I want you to understand it, that what we did really is, we kind of, you know, we transform the vector space V into the copy in Rn, you see? You give me something in the general vector space V, I connect it to what? I connect it to the Euclidean space, which is very interesting. And then we'll have some geometric interpretations. And that would be very useful when you work in some phenomena, you know, in physics, engineering disciplines, etc. Many, many applications of these, this type of ideas. It's quite interesting to be able to connect to the Euclidean space. So we can compare the properties of these two spaces. Okay, your job is to find it. And we give you one, maybe two parts. Okay, and there are three possibilities only. Just be patient to find them. Okay, this is it. Find. You have three on the practice quiz to practice. Find the coordinates. Okay, find the coordinate vector. Coordinate vector. They give you the vector. Vector V is equal to 3, 1, negative 4. Okay, relative to the base, to the bases. And this is going to be a basis. The basis is called with these vectors. 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, and 0, 0, 1 in R3. Okay, that's it. So you don't have to prove this is a basis. It's already given to you. So you have to, this is the vector. You have to write it down as a linear combination of these three. And you find those coefficients, C1, C2, and C3. And that give you the vectors that you're going to be interested in. Okay, so that's it. Let's do it, solution. So we are going to suppose you have a C1, C2, and C3 are going to be a scalar. Okay, scalars such that your vector V is going to be equal to the C1 V1, if you like, C2 V2, and the C3 V3. Okay, so as usual, I'm going to call this one V1, and this is going to be the V2 and the V3. Okay, you let them equal to each other, and then get the system of the equation, but this time you have to solve that system, okay? So if you substitute, so your V is what? Your V is 3, 1, and negative 4. Substitute for the other one. C1 times B1 would be 1, 1, 1. C2, 0, 1, 1. Okay, C3, 0, 0, 1. Okay, put them together and get your system of the equation. So this is going to be, in fact, if you like, this is going to be, you get the C1, here you get the 0 and 0, comma. The second component would be C1, this is C2, and this is going to be 0, comma. The third component would be C1, C2, and the C3. You see, that's it. We'll let them to be equal to each other. Okay, each component, C1 equal to 3, C1 plus C2 equal to the 1, and the C1 plus C2 plus C3 equal to the negative 4. So that gives you a system of three equations. Remember, you have to solve it this time. because you would like to get the C1, C2 and the C3, okay? So going to the other page and take care of it. So the system that we have to solve is the following. A coefficient to be equal to each other, so we get a C1 equal to 3. The second part, we get a C1 plus C2 equal to 1. And the last part that gives us C1 plus C2 plus C3 equal to -4. A system of three equations, three variables, you have to solve it. You already got the first one. Okay, so you already got the fact that the C1 is equal to 3. So that's a C1. Drop it here. So that gives you 3 plus C2 equal to 1. So that gives you the C2, which is going to be a -2. Okay, that's going to be your C2. And you put them here. C1 is equal to 3. Okay, the C2 is 2. And the C3 equal to the -4. So that gives you what? It's going to be 1 plus C3. Equal to the -4, so the C3 would be -5. That's it. So what's going to be your vector? You see, this is it. This is going to be the coordinate vector respect to the B is equal to, there you are, C1 comma C2, C3, which is, okay, 3, negative 2, 3, negative 2, and negative 5. So that gives you the final answer. Okay, any question? So that's, you know, that's the way you do it. Remember, this is in R3. We did it with respect to these bases. There is a standard base. Just give you a remark. It would be useful. You see the remark for this problem. The remark for this problem is, remember the standard base? Note that IJK, or just, you know, just say give you E1, E2, E3. Okay, and note that if we get a P equal to IJK, or we refer to the E1, E2, and E3. Okay, where we already introduced this, going to be 1, 0, 0. Okay, and the E2 is 0, 1, 0. And the E3 equal to the 0, 0, 1. This is the standard base, okay, is the standard. Okay, standard basis in R3. Okay, usually denote this one by S. Okay, let's call it S. Okay, S is going to be the case. Okay, it's going to be a standard base. In this case, okay, what is going to be this one? In this case, you see, if you want to find the coordinate vectors, okay, look at the one that you have. So your vector was what? Your vector was V. Remember, your V was what? It was 3, 1, and the -4. You know that since they are a standard, this would be simply 3E1 plus E2 minus 4E3 is IJK. So those C1, C2, C3 that we talk about it, you see, C1, C2, C3 is going to be, so if you want to find it with respect to the standard base, just the coordinate vectors. You see, this is going to be the same thing. So make sure you understand the difference. If you change the bases, you are going to have different coordinate vectors. So if your basis is going to be the one that's given to you, so the coordinate would be 3, negative 2, negative 5. But if you want, consider the respect to the standard one is as is. You see, in the case of the standard, this is already, because of the R3, This is ordinarily coordinated, the coordinate vectors. Okay, so this is going to be the case for the okay, for the unit vectors. We should have one with the polynomials. Another standard one, okay. So it's easy operation, but you have to find the C1, C2, and the C3. So I give you another one, and this is going to be, you need three example, and you have to order the three on there. Your practice one, we just give you a practice one, the solution one. Okay, that's it. Suppose, V is equal to the Pn. Remember, it's a vector space of a polynomials. Sorry, I want to consider only P2. It's going to be P2. Just let you know that the P2 is going to be the vector space. The polynomials of degree at most 2. Okay, it's going to be the vector space. Vector space of polynomials with degree, okay, degree at most 2 means less than equal to 2. Okay, this is going to be the case. So what we would like to do is we'd like you to find the coordinate vector. Find the coordinate vector of this vector, okay, of the v equal to the 2x squared minus 5x plus 6 relative to. Okay, find it relative to the following basis. To the basis. This is it. This is given to you. The base is 1, x minus 1, and the x squared minus 2x plus 1. You don't have to prove that this is going to be a basis for P2, it's already given to you. Okay. So you have a basis here. So this means every vector in your vector space is a linear combination of the basic one. So you write it down as a linear combination of these three vectors to find the scalars. A scalar C1, C2, and C3 would form, okay, that coordinate vectors that you are going to be interested in. Okay, so that's a case two, if you like. Okay, so I have the vector, so I write it down as a linear combination, and then it's going to be an easy system of the equation. We solve that system, and we get our coordinate, you know, coordinate vectors. Okay, so let's go for it. This is it. You are going to suppose the scalars that you want to find. So for the solution, this is going to be the solution, and we suppose that we have the scalars. Suppose. C1, C2, and C3, okay, are going to be scalars, are scalars such that your vector V is going to be equal to the C1 V1, C2 V2, plus C3 V3. Okay, so you bring those functions, simplify it. What do you have? Your V is what? Your V is 2x squared minus 5x plus 6 equal to the C1 V1. What is your V1? V1 is 1 plus C2. C2 V2. What's a V2? X minus 1 plus C3 V3. What is the V3? X squared minus 2x plus 1. You know that in case of the polynomials, you have to simplify it, and you let the coefficient of the monomials of the same degrees to be equal to each other. So simplify it. It's going to be the 2x squared minus 5x plus 6 equal to, this is the C1 multiply C2x minus C2 multiply C3x squared minus 2C3x plus C3. Put them together. You have to rewrite it, order it. Okay, from the x squared, we have only one, C3x squared. And to put the x's together, you see the x's, so it's going to be plus. So the x's would be C2 minus 2C3x. And the number is going to be C1 minus C2 plus C3. Okay, so nicely factor all the x. You have to write it down as a polynomial. And then the coefficient to be equal to each other. This is it. You have these two to be equal to each other. Then this is it. And the constant. Okay, so what's going to be a system of the equation? The system is, we get the C3 equal to 2. Here we get the C2 minus 2C3 equal to the negative 5. The last one, we get the C1 minus C2 plus C3 equal to what? Equal to the 6. That's it. So we have to solve this system of the equation. From the first one, we already got the C3. Okay, so the C3 is equal to 2. Done. Okay, so we're done with the first part. Then we have to put the C3 here. So that gives you a C2 minus 2 times 2 equal to the negative 5. So that gives you negative 4. You move it to the other side. That gives you a negative. Okay. The negative 9. Let's check. It's the C2 minus 2. Okay, that's going to be the one. So I have, you know, it's a negative 4. That's going to be positive 4. So that gives me negative 1. So that's going to be your C2, and you drop them here. So the C1 is the missing one minus C2, which is going to be a plus 1. And the C2 and the 2 equal to the 6. So the C1 would be 3. Okay. So we have the vector. Okay, this is it. What is going to be the coordinate of this vector respect to the given base is C1, C2, C3. In this case, it's a C1 is 3, negative 1, and 2. And we're done. Okay, very, very nice, nice operation. And you will see in the next, section. Next section is a little bit tricky. That's why I just stop here for the quiz. Okay. Sometimes we can change these bases. So when we do the job, okay, in the application cases, sometimes you may like to get the different bases. Let me give you a relationship between these. Quite interesting one. But we just leave it here. And we talk about it. We talk about it later. Okay, so this is so far what you need for the basis to be able, you know, to continue. Okay, so there is a case with the okay. There are going to be a couple of tricky cases. You know, we talk about it later. So we want to get to know them quickly so that you get something out for this quiz. And then we are going to give you a little bit more of the property of the basis, okay? So there are a couple of nice theorem that we can talk about it. So for example, we can prove that you see, we can prove that if you have a basis, you see, you have in R3. In R3, the standard base is ijk. So we have only three elements. So that will tell us that all the other bases in R3 must have the same number of the vectors, which is going to be only 3. The other one is the fact that you put over here, because how do you know that this linear combination is unique? We can prove that if you have a basis, okay, for a vector space, so you know that basis would create a space. So every element in the vector space can be just uniquely as a linear combination of them. So I will post another brief one for you later, okay, to get to those theorem types that we needed for the next section. We can do it for the next section too. So that's why we leave it here, so that we're able to go through our problems just using these fundamentals and nothing else. So if I give you more information, some of those problems can be done quickly. But we need to stay to get these ideas first, and then after the quiz, we continue, okay? So you should be fine with this one to be able to do all the problems on the practice quiz. Okay, I post the solution for that practice quiz and also your quiz for the, okay, for Monday. Okay, I post this one quickly and I grade your test. Anything else, just email me. Email me if you want to meet on Zoom for any difficulty, problems, let me know in advance. Okay, have a good one. Take care. Bye-bye.